the oval portrait from your English literature book on page number 20. Please get ready with a pencil and you will write whatever meaning I'm going to tell you. Now, in this story is written by Edgar Allan Poe back in 1842. In early 18th century, it was written. And this story helps us to evaluate the importance of life over art, or you can say importance of reality over dreams. And it is a beautiful contrast between the passion and the reality, which was ignored just to follow the passion. So we have two main characters in this story. One is the narrator, a man whose background is hidden. We just know that he was badly wounded. He was injured. Nothing else is given there. And his servant, Pedro. Servant's name is given. His name is Pedro. And they were somewhere on the countryside in France. It is not clearly written why they were there and what was the reason behind them being there or how he got wounded. Nothing is given. But we just come to know that he was badly wounded and the narrator was carried to a very large house or mansion, which was abandoned. Nobody was living there. And it had it was haunted. Means it appeared to be haunted because it was abandoned for many years. And they go there and the narrator realizes that it was beautifully decorated. It was very beautifully decorated, but they managed to settle down in a small apartment, what is given there. We can say small room or a chamber there, where he realizes that there are many decorations. The most fascinating thing he noticed was the oval portrait of a young woman, the girl who has just transformed to a woman, and that portrait was a bit different from other portraits. There were many portraits there, but it was a bit different. There was something very different in that portrait. And initially, the narrator closes his eyes at first glance. And then after a few minutes, he opens his eyes and keeps on watching at the portrait, that oval portrait. Then he realized that there is some spell over it. There is some magic over it. Now he wants to know what the magic is. The setting is in a dark room. Candles are used. And it is a countryside. It is a large, very large house or a mansion or some somewhat palace-like. Okay. Very huge. Very, very huge. So he wants to know the detail of that painting. And he comes to know that the young woman or the maid in that painting was the painter's wife. And she was a very obedient wife. And painter was a passionate man. He was a very moody man. Instead of loving his newly wedded wife, he made her sit in front of him for days and days and weeks. And he made her painting. But in the end, when he exclaims and he is satisfied with his work, his painting, that he says it is real life-like painting, and he realizes that his wife was dead. So he missed the woman, he lost his wife just to follow his passion to paint her out. Instead of talking to her, instead of developing his relation with her, He just sat down for days and days and weeks and kept on painting. Everybody else who was there around them was noticing that the girl was losing her spirits and her health. But the painter was not at all concerned with that. He was just mad to complete his painting. So this was the gist of the story. Now we will continue. Open to page number 20. Open to page number 20. The Oval Portrait is a short story by Edgar Allan Poe, published in 1842. The story begins with Pedro, the servant. Now, the narrator's servant bringing the injured narrator to take shelter in an abandoned ghostly mansion, haunted mansion. In some spirits are there. When a house is logged for years and years, you all have that cobwebs there, and it gets dirty, dusty, and rats and snakes, every sort of thing get start living there. It's not a very lively place. So it appears to be ghostly or haunted. Abundant means deserted. Ghostly, very large, big house, palace-like. Among the many paintings and trophies that decorate one of the towers of mansion, the narrator discovers a life-like painting, lifelike, which appears to be real. The work was so perfect that it was just as that portrait will speak. It's just about to speak. Painter depicting, that is to represent or to show the head and shoulders of a young girl. What you can see me on the screen, my face and my shoulders are there. This much was painted. The narrator further read a chilling account. Chilling, sudden numbing fear. When he reads about that portrait, he feels scared. He's a bit scared because the reality was that when the painting was being painted, it was being painted, the person who was being painted died. She lost her life. So it gives an impression that her spirit was there in the painting. So this gives a chilling account. When he reads, it means a numb feeling of scare. It means he's feared, he's scared. Account is detailed, describing the disturbing circumstances surrounding the portrait. Means in what circumstances it was painted. Okay, now we'll begin with the chapter. The chateau into which my valet is the main service, chateau is a large country house somewhere in France, has brought me in my wounded condition to spend a night, was a place very gloomy. Gloomy, dull, depressing, means where you don't feel good, you don't feel happy there. Blended with grandeur, means it was richly decorated, very nicely arranged, everything was there. To all appearance, it had been temporarily and very lately abandoned. Abandoned is again deserted. We established to settle down, to halt, to take a rest there, to occupy that place for a particular time, for a duration. Ourselves in one of the smallest and the least sumptuously furnished apartments. Least sumptuously means which was less expensive. Where there were decorations and the things kept were less expensive in comparison to the rest of the mansion. So they went there. It lay in a remote turret of the building, remote away, lay located. Turret, small tower of the building, as you can see in the picture just above this paragraph, its decorations were rich, yet tattered and empty. Decorations, pieces like in olden days, people used to decorate their halls with the armor suit or some swords on the wall, as we have read in the hen story, na, that a sword was there. Okay, and so maybe the head of a lion, which was a trophy of a victorious hunting. So these sort of decorations were there. Tattered means torn or ragged. Antique, very old, which belongs to some years back, very, 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 very old. Its walls were hung with the tapestry, very long curtains to hide walls, and bedecked is decorated with numerous type types of trophies together with an unusually great number of very modern paintings in rich golden ornate frames. Means most of the paintings were having a golden frame around them. It was not about the shape. They may be square or they may be rectangle or the oval. This about the that this portrait was oval in shape. Ornate is heavily decorated. Trophies, different types of weapons, lions, head, armors, they were used to decorate. Okay. These paintings fascinated me. Means the narrator admired them. He liked them very much. He was very much fascinated with those paintings. Therefore, I bade is instructed Pedro to close the heavy shutters. These mansions have very big doors now, so they appear like shutters. So he asked him to shut it off the room since it was already night. Means the sun was set and night was there. I asked him to light the very long candles which stood by the room head of my bed, means next to the head of the bed, and to throw wide apart the curtains of black velvet. Means the bed was having curtain around him, as we can see in old movies or in some haunted serials or movies, the big curtains around the bed, old bed. So he asked him to open it out, put it aside. What was the purpose? So he can see if he is not sleepy. Around the bed itself, and wished is desired all this to be done so that if I could not sleep, I could ponder is to consider or to think thoroughly on these paintings or read the big book which was placed on the pillow. There was a book there. It has got all details about the paintings which were there in that mansion. I spent a long time reading and gazing around the room. He was just reading. He was trying to kill his time. He was just trying to pass his time by reading. Rapidly and gloriously, the hours flew by and the deep midnight came. Rapidly, very quickly. Means he was not bored there, that he was thinking the time is not passing. He was busy reading and the time passed quickly and wonderfully. Means he was enjoying reading the book there. Flew by and the deep midnight came. The position of the candle displeased me. He felt like shifting it. He was not satisfied with the position of the candle. He wanted it to shift from the place they were kept to some other place. And outreaching my hand, means as he was half lying, he was on the bed and he was wounded also. So he must be having pain in his body with difficulty. That's why he tried to outreach and try to shift. He did not get up from his bed, and he tried to adjust the position of the candle. Rather than disturb my sleeping valet, the helper, the male servant, I placed it so as to throw its light more fully upon the book. Throw light to receive, to get. Means he wanted more light to fall on his book. With this purpose, he changed the position of the candle. Okay?